I can really get to meet him. I live in Seattle, right, all the time, and I'm like, Good morning, everyone. It's 10 o'clock. It's the scheduled time for a special call meeting. And if I could ask everyone to silence their cell phone and please stand and join me in the pledge of the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. Adoption of the agenda. I hear a motion agenda be adopted as presented.
I make a motion.
Motion is second. All in favor? Okay, appointment of a qualified person to fill the vacancy caused by the retirement and termination of service of Councilmember Rupert Sexton, post one. First of all, let me say I appreciate all the calls that I've received in reference to this and citizens who would like to be appointed, and a lot of my friends, and I certainly take it all very seriously. And I have talked to a lot of people in the last week, 10 days, and the person that I'd like to recommend to the board is a person I think that led certain credibility. He's been in politics. He's retired, and he's a person who don't want to run for the office. He said he would do a favor for the city of Cumming and the citizens of Cumming, and he would not be a candidate for the unexpired term of post one. So the person I'd like to recommend to the council that be appointed to serve the interim, which will be from now until an election is held, which will only be about 2 months. So this person will only serve about 2 months, and then the election will be fulfilled with a candidate out of whoever runs for post one, and then they'll take over. So the person I'd like to recommend to the board is Doug Sorrells. Doug is a city resident. He has served as clerk of court along with many other over his career, and he's retired, but he will take this appointment for the interim post one if appointed, and that's my recommendation to the board. So I'll entertain a motion for that.
Mayor, I'll make a motion for that.
I have a motion from Ralph that we appoint Doug Sorrells for the interim vacancy of post one until election can be held to fill that post. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second, Princeton. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Yeah. Any opposed? Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item four, consideration of a resolution for the purpose of calling a special election to fill the unexpired term of Councilman Rupert Sexton, post one. And
thank you, Mr. Mayor, members of the council. In front of you in your packet is a two-page resolution, which I'm going to read the heading of and the highlights of very quickly for you to consideration. This is a resolution for the City of Cumming, Georgia, for the purpose of calling a special election on June 16, 2015, to fill the unexpired term of Councilmember Rupert Sexton, who retired and removed himself from office. Set dates for qualification to request to continue assistance Forsyth County Board of Elections to conduct a special election on June 16, 2015, and for other purposes. That's the title. In essence, what this resolution provides in accordance with both the city's charter and state law is that there will be a qualification period of May 12, 13, and 14, obviously this year. That the qualification fee is $180 to qualify, obviously, with the clerk here, Tony. That there will be a special election held in accordance with state law and the date set by the Georgia Secretary of State's office on June 16, 2015, which will be held here at City Hall in the Cumming precinct, the place where everybody in the city traditionally votes. That the person that is elected at that special election will be sworn in. The election day is also your council meeting day, just fortuitously in June. So the election's on June 16th. Your council meeting will occur prior to the time that the polls close. The person could not be sworn in on that day. They wouldn't be eligible to be sworn in until your July meeting, which is July 21st of this year. And then they would serve from then through the remainder of the postponed term, which would be December 31st of 2017. In essence, there's approximately 2.5 years left on this postponed term. That's what the resolution provides. I respectfully ask that there be a motion and second to pass this resolution. If you see fit to pass it, Mr. Honey has the original that will circulate for your signature. And the actual call of the election, which is also in your packet, which just notifies the public of this, in addition to people that are hearing about it from today, will be published in the Forsyth County News at least next Wednesday. And we're hopeful, if you see fit to pass it, we'll publish it both Sunday and Wednesday. It has to be published at least one time, but we want to ask it to be published twice. To make as many people aware as possible. Because the Sunday edition is the largest circulation in America. You go ahead and answer any questions, Mr. Chairman.
Councilman, I need to, does this resolution need to be read into the minutes?
It is part of the minutes. I read the title, and I tried to summarize what it said as opposed to reading word for word. And it will be part of the minutes if you see fit to pass in its entirety.
All right. Thank you very much. Councilman, any questions? This is for the special election to fill the unexpired term, Councilman Sexton, which is June 16th.
The June 16th will be the option for the postponed unexpired term, formally occupied by Councilman Sexton.
I have a motion.
Thank you, motion. We have a special election for those one vacancy in June of this year.
Second.
I have a motion and a second.
Just
any other discussion?
Just for clarification, and pass this resolution. So yes.
Yes.
Thank you. I'm sorry, sir.
Any other discussion? Motion is second. All in favor? Raise your hand. Unanimous.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sexton. I see that you're sitting out there. Do you have an office? I didn't know where you'd been cleaned out or not. Do you think you need to get out of your office?
No, I've already got.
Do you have anything that needs to be turned over to the city company, belongs to the city?
Yes, I've got keys. Card and key ready.
You would turn that over to the city manager, and that'd be fine. I hear motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion to appoint some second John Day. All in favor? Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good morning, Father. are lovely portraits. Maybe we can have you hold it up. Hold your portrait up. Certainly.
So I'll see our picture.
Yeah. How about, are we allowed to go in the closet? Is that okay? Is that open?
Yeah.
That would be a good place. We're not really ready to go.
Interview. You want to put those on it?
Sure. That's perfect. Excellent. I like that. That is really nice. Okay. All right. Now, I like that. Now, all we need is the councilman. You got to stand with all your stuff here.
You need to get in there, too. Take that jacket off, please.
Okay.
Take this one off, too, I guess. I'm gonna be in this.
That's really nice. I like that. Okay. And Kathleen, feel free to chime in if you have suggestions. That's fine with you too. Actually, if you would stand to the right of your portrait. And we'll get you
and smile, please.
Yeah, let me just get this over just a little.
Act like you're happy about this retirement. So, yay, you want to see the grandbaby? Woohoo!
Okay, let's make sure that's not going to slide. Here we go. Okay, if you can stand here, and then we'll get.
Just let me know if I'm your way.
I like that a lot. That's really nice. Playing musical chairs here, so pardon me. I'm just going to move this around and make sure I have you in here. Oh, that's really nice. I like
smile. Smile. Woo. Say Lily Jane. Lily Jane. I can't get her name out. My daughter named her such a long name.
Would you stand on the other side? Yeah, that's nice. Okay, I'm going to get you in there too. I like that. That's very lovely.
Get one of us together too.
I'll do a couple combinations here. I like that. Congratulations, Councilman Sexton, on 44 years of service. That's quite an accomplishment. I mean, that's a major milestone. You have put the majority of your life into
58% of my adult life.
Tell us how you first were elected. On the council, and what prompted you to run for office?
There were 15 candidates that ran for five offices, and out of 15 candidates, I was number one, got more votes than any of the rest of them, and that's where post 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 came in, and wanted to finish in that race in 1970.
And what prompted you to run? What was the impetus for you throwing your hat in the ring?
Didn't have nothing else to do.
What was your profession besides being a city councilman?
My what?
Your profession.
auto sales. I've been auto sales and insurance for 46 years.
And when did you retire from your auto sales?
In 87.
And when did you retire from your insurance business?
Last year.
So that's fairly recently.
Mm-hmm.
And you just had a birthday a week ago, I think?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And
77.
Okay, 77 years old. That is a major milestone. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I admire you. And how do you feel about your retirement from the city council?
It's been a burden lifted off of me. The pressure the pressure is going away.
So you feel relieved and
I'm back to John Q. Public now.
So you're one of us now.
I'm John Q. Public now.
And that's not a bad thing at all.
Mm-hmm.
And Dana, how do you feel about your husband retiring after
44
years?
I'm excited. It was fun. It wasn't fun the last couple of 3 months.
I understand there's a lot of stress with the accusations from the council and
mm-hmm.
from alleging improperly disclosing confidential insurance information. However, that's questionable. It appears to be that it's a public record, and
right.
So they,
yeah, that was very ridiculous.
They attempted to impeach Councilman Sexton and realized, I guess, that wasn't the proper thing to do. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
No, I really don't want to get into it.
Certainly, that's fine.
No, it was just a scam to hide their own corruption. That's all I can say.
Okay, and so Councilman Sexton, or actually, I guess it's Mr. Sexton or Councilman, I think we can still call you that, is what's the word? Emeritus. when they try to impeach you, I mean, what was your reaction? What was your thought about all of that?
I hadn't done anything. And what the records that were made public is a public record anyway.
I tend to agree. It appears that mm-hmm. way. There was nothing confidential or
nope.
medical. They were just lists of employees and their insurance premiums.
It was a simple spreadsheet. I mean, there was nothing on there HIPAA protected. The word HIPAA protected, I mean, there was nothing on it.
Yeah.
It was a list of names, date of hire, that was it.
Family
insurance premium.
You're paying the cops.
So what were the biggest surprises when you got the spreadsheet, when you found that information?
I discovered that there was two individuals on there that wasn't city employees.
And who were those two individuals?
That was Ms. Mullinax and attorney Miles.
Okay. The city attorney Dana Miles and Ms. Angela Mullinax, who
yeah.
is a lady friend of Mayor Ford Gravitt.
Right. Correct.
Okay. Very good.
Just never received a city's paycheck. Ever.
That begs a lot of questions, and of course the FBI is now investigating insurance records and travel records and employment records of
mm-hmm.
individuals here at the city. So hopefully they'll discover, get to the bottom of all of that.
We're hoping.
So, is there anything you'd like to say, parting comments, Mrs. Sexton?
You probably don't want to hear my comments. At least not on camera.
Well enough. And Mr. Sexton, is there a final comment you would like to share with us? And
well, I've worked for my employer for 44 years, and my employer was the citizens of Cumming. And I want to thank each and every one of them that has supported me over the past 44 years.
Very nice. Well said. Mrs. Sexton, you want to give your husband a hug goodbye from the city council?